Ito pangako ko sa inyo. Kapag ka may kasinungalingan po akong sinabi dito po sa aking programa, isasarado ko po ang channel ko at page ko. Hindi na po ako magpo-political vlog. Pero nakakasigurado kasi ako, lahat po ng sinasabi po natin dito ay nakabase po sa tamang kaalaman, tamang balita at paglaban sa mga fake news at kasinungalingan, partikular na pinapakalat ng mga Duterte. Ngayon, ang tanong, si Rodrigo Duterte ba sa inyo pong paniniwala ang pinakawalang kwentang naging pangulo ng Pilipinas? Kasi kung ako po ang tatanungin ninyo, ito pong si Rodrigo Duterte ang pinakawalang kwenta na naging pangulo ng Pilipinas. Ano-ano po ang aking mga basihan? Unang-una, ito po ay mambubudol. Bakit po? Ang naging panghikayat niya sa ating mga kababayang Pilipino para po mahalal bilang pangulo ng Pilipinas noong 2016 ay labanan ang ilegal na droga, kriminalidad at korupsyon. Pero nangyari po ba yan? Hindi po. Sapagkat sa pamumuno niya, samut-saring kontrobersiya po ang nalalantad. Pero nung mga panahong iyon, hindi po mabigyan ng kaukulang atensyon dahil hawak niya nga po ang ehekutibo at hindi talaga maimbestigahan. Pero ngayon, unti-unti na pong lumalabas ang mga baho na yan. Kasinungalingan ba na sabihin po natin na sa panahon ng panunungkulan ni Rodrigo Duterte, napasukan po no other than ang Bureau of Customs ng bilyong-bilyong halaga po ng illegal na droga. And that's why ito pong si dating commissioner Pael Nicanor Faeldon ay kanya pong inalis dahil humarap na po ito sa napakalaking kontrobersiya. Pero dahil napalakas nitong si Nicanor Faeldon kay Rodrigo Duterte, imbis na ibasura po ito, ay kanya po itong inilipat lamang at bilang pinuno pa ng Bureau of Customs, a Bureau of Correction. At doon po sa Bureau of Corrections, napakalaki na namang kontrobersiya ang bumalot po sa pagkatao o performance o pamumuno nito pong si Nicanor Faeldon. Walang iba tayong tinutukoy kung hindi ang good conduct time allowance, kung saan sinasabi na ang dami daw pong nagbabayad para lamang po mabigyan ng GCTA, good conduct time allowance. At dahil nga po pressure na, wala na siyang nagawa talaga itong si Rodrigo Duterte kung hindi finally bitawan na po ito pong si Nicanor Faeldon. Isa lamang po yan sa mga sitwasyon na palpak itong si Rodrigo Duterte, partikular sa paglaban sa illegal na droga. Ilan po sa mga kapalpakan nitong si Rodrigo Duterte sa pakikipaglaban sa illegal na droga ay mapapakinggan po natin sa nangyaring quad committee hearing ng Kongreso kanina. At ang mga committee po na bumubuo po rito, apat po, kaya nga po quad, ay ang mga sumusunod. Committee on Public Order, Committee on Dangerous Drugs, Committee on Public Accounts, and Committee on Human Rights. Sa bawat pagsasalita o opening statement ng mga chairperson ng mga committee na yan, inilihad po doon ang mga kawalang kwentang pangyayari sa pamumuno po nitong si Rodrigo Duterte. Pero before nating puntahan ang quad hearing na yan kanina dyan sa House of Representatives, banggitin din po natin ang napakarami, o iilan na lamang pala kasi mauubos ang oras natin yung mga hindi katanggap-tanggap na mga pangyayari sa panahon ni Rodrigo Duterte, kung bakit din natin sinasabing number one budulero ito, ay ang pagsasabi niya na ipagtatanggol niya ang ating karapatan sa South China Sea na kinikilala po nating West Philippine Sea. Sa panahon ng halalan, sabi niya, even siya ay magje-jetski doon at itatatag ang ating bandila para lamang patunayan na talagang mahal niya ang bansa, ang mga Pilipino at ang parte, karagatan ng Pilipinas ay dapat ipagtanggol at sa atin. Marami po ang nabudol sa mga pahayag na yon ni Rodrigo Duterte, sapagkat ilang buwan pa lamang ang nakakalipas sa kanyang pamumuno bilang Pangulo, Oktubre 2016. Nakipagkita na kaagad siya sa presidente po ng China na si President Xi Jinping sa isang state visit. At doon po inilahad niya ang pagyukod niya sa China. Kasi bakit natin sinasabing pagyukod niya? Tinalikuran niya ang napakahaba na natin pong relasyon na maganda sa Estados Unidos at ilang pang mga like-minded countries para lamang po paboran ang kagustuhan ng China. Sa pag-aakala na makakatulong ito for one reason, pero I believe, meron kasi akong tatlong paniniwala na kung bakit ito pong si Rodrigo Duterte ay naging tuta ng China. Unang-una, siya ay merong kapakinabangan na nakukuha sa China. Ito naman po ay hindi chismis, kung hindi opinion ko lamang. Hindi ko sinasabing totoo, pero sa aking isipan, naglalaro ang mga pangyayari na yan na maaaring may katotohanan o wala. Unang-una, siya po ay nagkaroon ng malaking kapakinabangan sa China. Kaya po, pagyukod niya talaga sa China ang gagawin niya. Pangalawa, ito pong si Rodrigo Duterte ay uto-uto. Kasi sinasabi po ng China na tutulungan tayo para mapaunlad ang ating bansa. Pero hindi naman po nangyari yon. Ang dami pong mga economic investment or pledges na ginawa po ng China na hindi naman po naisakatuparan. Ikatlo, ito pong si Rodrigo Duterte ay talagang duwag o matapang lamang sa pagsasalita. Kaya nung sabihin ni President Xi Jinping na huwag kang mag-explore ng langis dyan o kung anuman na nais nyo sa West Philippine Sea, ay agad po siyang yumukod sapagkat takot siya na baka gerahin po tayo ng China. Which is hindi naman mangyayari. Ang China, hindi po tayo gegerahin yan, mga tol. Hindi nila uunahin ang pagputok. Kasi pag ginawa po nila yan, tutulungan tayo, particular ng Estados Unidos. Magkakaroon ng rason para mag-activate yung defense, mutual defense treaty ng Pilipinas at ng Estados Unidos. Kaya never po tayong gegerahin ng China. Huwag naman sana na ang Pilipinas ang unang magpaputok kasi pagka ganun ang nangyari, eh gagamitin ngayon ng China ang buong pwersa nila para durugin ang Pilipinas. Ganun pa man, yan lamang ay mga opinion ko at hindi ko po sinasabing totoo yan o hindi rin ko rin sinasabing walang katotohanan. Opinion ko lamang yan, naglalaro sa aking isipan, kaya nga ako sinasabing ito pong si Rodrigo Duterte ang pinakawalang kwentang naging pangulo ng Pilipinas. Sa panahon din po ng kanyang panunungkulan, naging laganap ang isang illegal sa China pero pinahintulutan niya po rito na maglipa na sa pamamagitan po ng kanyang de facto policy about Pogo nang sabihin niya po sa harapan ng publiko that Pogo is good. Eh, para pong mga kabuti po itong nagsisulputan sa ating bansa at ito po ay nag-create ng mga napakaraming negatibong produkto, particular krimen, pang-aabuso at kung ano-ano pang mga irregularidad. Ilan po sa mga kriminalidad na naka-attach po sa Pogo ay ang pagpatay, pag-torture, human trafficking at money laundering. Lahat po iyan ngayon ay iniimbestigahan na. At ang pinaka-worst talaga sa lahat, mga tol, at hindi katanggap-tanggap, na kapwa mo Pilipino, ipapapatay mo. Ayon po sa datos, nung una akala natin ito po ay nasa 6,000 mahigit lamang, kinalauna naging 7,000 mahigit lamang, pero sa isang hearing na nangyari sa House of Representatives, ibinulgar ni Attorney Chel Jocno na ayon po sa isang dokumento na itinuring na accomplishment ng Duterte administration at ginamit na parte ng resolusyon ng Korte Suprema from July 1, 2016 to November 27, 2017, there were 20,322 deaths na kinonsidera pong accomplishment ng Duterte administration. Even ang nasa 16,000 po rito ay itinuturing na death under investigations para sa gobyerno back then or extrajudicial killing pagdating po sa mga kritiko ng Duterte administrations. Yan po talaga ang pinaka hindi naging katanggap-tanggap sa lahat ng naging parte ng pamumuno nitong si Rodrigo Duterte. Thousands of lives killed. Thousands of families were shattered. At igit sa lahat, hanggang ngayon, ito pong mga pamilya na ito na nawalan po ng mahal sa buhay ay naghahanap po ng katarungan. At dahil po sa punto na yan, nagkaroon na po tuloy ng tinatawag na pagkakaisa doon po sa House of Representatives, dahil ang tinutumbok lagi ng mga committee na pinanggit po natin kanina ay halos nagkakapare-parehas na. Kaya nabuo po ngayon yung Quad Committee diyan po sa House of Representatives. At pakinggan po natin ito pong mga nangyari kanina diyan po sa House of Representatives. Ang una pong magsasalita, syempre ang tumatayong taga-pamuno sa Quad Committee na yan, na si Congressman Ace Barber. Kasama niya po dyan sina Congressman Abante, Congressman Dan Hernandez, Congressman, di ko maalala ang mga pangalan, bahala na po kayo at pakinggan na po natin sila.
Deliver a short welcome remarks and as well as an opening statement of the Quadcom, being the lead chairperson of the said committee. Good afternoon, honorable co-chairman, esteemed colleagues. Welcome to the organizational meeting of the joint four committees referred to as Quadcom. This historical and unprecedented committee is the product of a resolution and privileged speeches which tasked the committee to address an urgent matter of national concern and importance. Needing the consolidation of the investigations being done by four major committees, namely Committee on Dangerous Drugs, Committee on Public Accounts, Committee on Public Order and Safety, and Committee on Human Rights. It came about when things became clear that the four committees are investigating issues that are interrelated, interconnected, and intertwined. Our individual investigations confirmed the existence of big Chinese organized crime syndicate operating in our shores with the intention of undermining the security of our government. The investigations confirmed what we have long suspected. The syndicate has been operating for quite a long time already. This well-organized syndicate floods the country with dangerous drugs in probable connivance with corrupt officials and employees of the government agencies and possibly local government officials. Drugs destroy societies. Its uncontrolled proliferation was the main culprit why thousands of our countrymen were allegedly executed without benefit of due process. To date, we are painstakingly putting the pieces together in the hope of giving justice to the victims. As if the tons upon tons of dangerous drugs were not enough, the syndicate brought in hot money into the country to wash and launder in casinos and pogos. Once legitimized, the money is then used to buy influence in government. This influence enables the members of the syndicate to corrupt even more government workers who then issue identification papers, cards, and certifications based on falsified information, leading to their assumption of fake Filipino identities and citizenships. Agencies tasked to oversee and evaluate applications will have a lot of explaining to do, as they all invoke the so-called ministerial duties in accepting and processing applications. Once done, the syndicate formed corporations pretending to be Filipinos. The regulatory agency in charge, which never even bothered to undertake due diligence as to the real citizenship or citizenships and qualifications of those applicants, likewise invoked ministerial duties as their mandate in registering all these corporations. These dubious Filipino-controlled corporations then engage in a buying spree of properties, real estate, drug and pogo money being their main capital. Thanks to the great assistance of some local government officials and employees who facilitated these illegal transactions, of course, for a hefty fee or price, of course. To perpetuate this illegal activity, there has to be unlimited source of funds. Thus, drugs continue to flood our shores and pogos became the hubs of all kinds of criminality, such as kidnap for ransom, murders, tortures, human trafficking.
Ito, pakinggan nyo po yung mga sinasabi ng respective chairperson ng Quad Committee na yan, ha? Kasi yan po yung produkto ng kanilang hearing in aid of legislation. At ngayon, kinoconsolidate na lamang nila kasi ang mga end product, ika nga, tumutukoy sa mga pare-parehas na tao. At ang pinaka-worst dyan, ang dating Pangulo ng Pilipinas na dadamay ngayon. Ha? Kaya dapat malaman po natin ito. Kung wala naman pong maling ginawa si Rodrigo Duterte, napakadali naman siguro magsalita sa harapan ng publiko sa pamamagitan ng pagsagot ng sa mga katanungan ng mga kongresista na ito. Pero ayaw po nilang dumalo eh. Kaya nga mamaya dyan, tatanungin ni Congressman, Congresswoman, sino ba yung na-convict? Congresswoman Franz Castro. What if hindi dumalo itong si Rodrigo Duterte? Pwede bang i-apply sa kanya ang rules ng Kongreso? O malalaman po natin yan mamaya. For the meantime, pakinggan po natin ang mga opening statement po dito nito pong mga chairperson ng apat na committee na yan.
Trafficking, money laundering, cyber crimes, cyber scams, and other unspeakable crimes. Pogo, an entity completely alien in our culture until Executive Order Number 13 was issued because a monster and became a monster almost overnight. In the guise of being a savior by bringing in much needed revenues that the government may use for healthcare and other priority projects, Pogo turned out to be a dud and revealed its true color as the worst curse any government system could ever face. Pogos, in reality, became the faster vehicle for the members of the syndicates to come ashore and become legitimate visitors, investors, students, and even citizens. No thanks to the dozens of agencies empowered to issue all kinds of visas for a price, again, of course. That likewise empowered the syndicate to operate almost unnoticed and unhampered, and even protected by some members of our own law enforcement agencies. Now it becomes the daunting task of this new committee to continue in a unified and stronger front what the individual committees have started, in the hope of crafting legislative solutions as well as assist greatly in the prosecution and conviction of the perpetrators.
Okay, linawin natin ha, kasi maraming nagsasabi, no, wala namang kwenta yung mga pinagagagawa ng mga kongresista na yan, even ng mga senador. Puro kayo hearing, wala naman nangyayari. Let us remember, mga tol, na ang functions po ng legislative branch of the government is to enact laws. Ano, at sa pamamagitan po ng mga hearing na ito, nakakabalangkas po sila ng mga batas. Pagdating po sa prosecution, dapat malinaw sa atin, wala po silang kapangyarihan para po mag-prosecute ng sino man. Pero meron po silang mandato na mag-assist, in particular, mag-recommend kung sino yung mga pwedeng kasuhan base sa mga nakalap po nilang mga ebidensya, either pieces of physical evidence, documentary evidence, or testimonial evidence. Dapat malinaw po sa atin yon. Kasi baka hanapan po natin sila ng resulta dito, tapos yung resultang hinahanap natin, eh hindi naman nila kayang gawin. Katulad po ng pagsasampa ng kaso, if ever, dito kay na Rodrigo Duterte, hindi po kayang gawin yon ng House of Representatives. Ang magagawa po nila ay bumalangkas ng mga batas para yung mga sinasabing pagkakamali sa mga nakalipas na panahon na wala pa pong kaukulang batas, ay mabigyan na po ng atensyon at maparusahan kung may gagawa po ng mga bagay na yun. Kasi tandaan natin, merong kasabihan sa batas, yung nullum crimen, nulla poena sine lege, ang ibig pong sabihin ng Latin maxim na yan, sa madaling paliwanag na lamang, ay hanggat wala pong nasusulat na batas para ipagbawal ang isang bagay, kapag ka ito po ay ginawa ng isang tao, hindi po ito pwedeng parusahan. Kaya sa ganung punto po, pumapasok ito pong mga mambabatas na kapag ka sa tingin po nila ang isang akto na wala pong batas na nagbabawal dito pero hindi po maganda, ang maaaring maging epekto po nito sa bansa at sa mga mamamayan po nito, eh kailangan po nilang mag-akto ng batas para po ipagbawal ang akto na yon. Hanggang dito na lamang, mga tol, muna yung mga sinasabi ko. Balik po tayo rito po sa pakikinig sa mga kongresista.
conspirators and masterminds of the whole criminal network. By unmasking them and exposing their activities through this wide congressional investigation, we promise that we will leave no stone unturned until we have finally solved the puzzle. So thank you very much and good afternoon to all our members present today.
Okay, habang...
Representative Dan Fernandez, you are recognized.
Oh, yan na.
Senior Deputy Speaker, Congressman Aurelio...
Si Dan Fernandez ay chairperson, I hope tama ako, ng Committee on Public Order. Pakinggan po natin siya dito, no?
Pante, Chairman Carafs.
Ah, hindi
po. And to our colleagues, members of this...
Oh, si Congressman Dalipi pala ang unang magsasalita.
The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing.
Ito, lagi po nating naririnig yan at madalas sinasabi po natin dito sa ating programa. Yung pahayag o quote na nanggaling po kay Edmund Burke, di ba? Sabi niya, the only thing for an evil to triumph is for a good man to do nothing. Tama yung pagkakaalala ko. Pero simple lang naman yung mga tol eh. Kapag wala po tayong ginagawa sa isang bagay na nakikita po natin na masama, nakikita po natin na ginagawa ng iba na hindi tama, para po nating pinapahintulutan na manaig ang kasamaan at tinotolerate na rin po natin ito. Kaya sa madaling paliwanag, huwag po tayong manahimik kapag meron po tayong nakikitang mali. Magsalita po tayo. Yan po ang nararapat. Pakinggan natin patuloy si Congressman Gonzales Dalipe. I'm sorry, ha? Pakicorrect niyo po ako kung sino siya.
That is Edmund Burke.
Ah, I'm sorry. Nakasulat
ladies and gentlemen,
na pala dito.
Good afternoon.
Nakasulat na pala si Congressman Gonzales. I'm sorry.
4 months, our country has been hounded by issues on extrajudicial killings linked to the previous administration, the war on drugs, continuous prevalence in the manufacture and trafficking of illegal drugs in the country, and the criminal activities associated with the now banned Philippine offshore gaming operators. We in the House of Representatives did not sit idly by, and we acted upon these issues with urgency and inherent resolve. In fact, the Committees on Public Accounts and Dangerous Drugs, Public Order, and Safety and Human Rights conducted numerous inquiries to pinpoint the root cause of these issues and find the people accountable in perpetuating these human atrocities. These meetings were conducted based on their respective jurisdictions and prescribed by the 19th Congress, the rules of the House. This rundown of the recent investigations being conducted by the 4 committees. The Committee on Public Accounts investigated the anomalous and irregular purchase of 10,000 square meters of land in Mexico, Pampanga, wherein a certain A.D. Tai Young bought an agricultural parcel of land with an aggregate amount of 3 million pesos. Which he later sold to the local government unit with an exorbitant price of 29.5 million pesos. It was later revealed that Mr. Eddie Young is involved in a network of illicit activities with broader implications to national security. During the course of the investigation, it was found out that Eddie Tai Young is a Chinese national who illegally obtained a Filipino identity. He is likewise the CEO of Yatai Industrial Park and either an incorporator or connected with Yatai International, Omni, Sunflare, Golden Sun 999, among others. It was later identified that Edith Tai Young is likewise an incorporator of Empire 999, where a 3.6 billion peso worth or more than 560 kilos worth of shabu were seized in one of their warehouses. Meanwhile, the Committee of Dangerous Drugs investigated the seizure of illegal drugs in a warehouse in Mexico, Pampanga. Again, the confiscated drugs last September 2023 is considered the biggest drug haul of the Marcos administration at that time. During the proceedings, information provided by the SEC, Link Eddie Taiyang to a certain Willy Ong, both serving as incorporators of Empire 999. Both were Chinese nationals who are pretending to be Filipinos and who have obtained fake certificates of live births, passports, and other documents. The panel found that ex-Duterte advisor Michael Young's interpreter Lincoln Ong, a prominent figure of the Farmaly scandal, is also incorporated of a firm with alleged ties to all other shell activities, including Empire 999. The committee then invited Mr. Michael Young to shed light on the interlocking incorporators of all the corporations connected with Empire 999 Realty Incorporated. In his testimony, former police colonel Eduardo Acierto involved Michael Young in the illegal drugs trade in the country. Just recently, Mr. Young was cited in contempt due to his continuous absences in the proceedings and utter disregard for the invitation sent to him. On the other hand, the Committee on Public Order and Safety joined with the Committee on Games and Amusement discovered the connection of...
Singit tayo ng kaunti ah, para magkaroon tayo ng maikling konteksto sa sinasabi ni Congressman Gonzales. Ito po yung linkage ng illegal na droga sa panahon ni Rodrigo Duterte. Mula sa mga Chinese, particular sa kanyang economic advisor nung panahon na yon na si Michael Young. Oh. Kaya ngayon nalilink dito, hindi lamang yung mga personalidad na binanggit, kung hindi pati si Rodrigo Duterte. Okay? Isang punto pa lamang yan kasi bawat committee merong kanya-kanyang punto. Dito, illegal na droga ang pinakasentro ng pinag-uusapan.
Legal Philippine offshore gaming operators of illegal drug operations. Last August 5, House officials led Speaker Martin G. Romualdez and myself, Committee Chairpersons Dan Fernandez, Antonio Ferrer, Robert H. Barbers, Joseph Stephen Paduano, Romeo Jacob, Representative Johnny Pimentel and Janet Garin, and PAOCC Undersecretary General Gilbert Cruz visited Jun Yuan Technology Inc. in Bamban, Tarlac, Lucky South 999, Gaming Incorporated in Porac, Pampanga, and a warehouse owned by Empire 999 Realty Corporation in Mexico, Pampanga, where the $3.6 billion worth of illegal drugs was found. Finally, the Committee on Human Rights produced considerable output composed of testimonies of the kind of drug war victims that can potentially be used as additional evidence by ICC prosecutors in their pursuit of justice against the bloody campaign of war on drugs on the previous administration. Dinaluan po natin ang lahat ng committee meetings na ito. And in the course of these inquiries, I can positively deduce that the issues being scrutinized by each committee are correlated and intertwined with one another.
Correlated ha? And intertwined with one another. Sa Tagalog, magkakaugnay. Ha? Magkakaugnay po ang mga issue na ito. Kaya ngayon, pinagsama-sama po nila. Ha? Sa mga DD sheets po dyan na nanonood, kung sa tingin po ninyo, kasinungalingan ang lahat ng mga ito, wala po kaming magagawa. Nasa utak po kasi ninyo yan eh. Kung tanga kayo, wala na pong galing dyan sa katangahan ninyo. Pero huwag nyo na po kaming idamay kung tanga kayo. Sabi nga po sa opening statement nitong si Congressman Gonzales, the only thing for an evil to triumph is for a good man to do nothing. Diba? At hindi po kami ganun. Hindi po kami mananahimik. Ako, in particular, bilang vlogger, hindi ako magpapatakot kahit kanino. Ha? Kahit yung mga nagbabanta sa akin dyan, sinasabi ninyo, tapos ako, nak ng teting kayo. Ako, kahit bantaan nyo ako, di ako natatakot mamatay, pero wag muna sana ngayon. Kasi, syempre, ang pamilya ko umaasa sa akin. Pero di ako natatakot mamatay, mga ugok. Ha? Matatapang lang kayong magsalita. Pagbabantaan nyo pa ako, hahamunin nyo pa ako. Ito lang masasabi ko sa inyo. Ang kasalanan ko sa Diyos, di ko pumabilang. Di ko alam kung mapapatawad pa ako ng ating Panginoon. Ako, sa mga nagawa ko sa buhay, sigurado ko, maliban kung patawarin ako ng Diyos, impyerno ang pupuntahan ko. Ah, pag samasamahin nyo yung mga daliri nyo, isang didi sheet, ilan ba daliri natin? 10 sa kamay, 10 sa paa, kulang pa yan sa kasalanan ko sa Diyos. Anak ng teting kayo, tapos tatakutin nyo ako.
There were identical and common personalities involved, and there are intervening circumstances and interwoven issues based on factual antecedents and were discovered during the hearings. Kaya naman, I called for a joint investigation by the four committees during my privilege speech last August 5 to warrant a holistic and comprehensive submission of a report of the plenary. A unified investigation will strengthen on trust. Consolidating resources will give us faster results, which more than ever is critical as we are racing against time. A protracted investigation is utterly unacceptable because the stakes are too high and too precious to lose.
Ngayon, kung sinasabi ninyo na isasampal nyo sa akin ang Administrasyong Duterte, ang accomplishment nito, di sampal nyo sa akin. Ah, let us remember na kahit napakaraming nagawa po ng isang tao, hindi po yan lisensya para gumawa ko po ng pagkakamali. Kung marami mang accomplishment si Rodrigo Duterte, it doesn't mean nakakalimutan ang kanyang mga pagkakamali. Kung ang kaparaanan na nangyari ay mali, para lamang magresulta sa isang tama, mali pa rin po yun. The end does not justify the means. Ika nga. Ha? Naghahangad kang mawala ang illegal na droga, pero ang kaparaanan mo, patayin ang mga libo-libong Pilipino, mali po yun. At kung sinusuportahan mo yun, tanga po kayo. Ako, bahagi ako ng war on drugs. Alam ko sa level namin kung ano yung mga nangyari. Pero di ako magsasalita. Magkapit-pita na nga ng bayag. Bakit ako magsasalita? Wala naman akong kaso din kinakaharap.
Through our collective efforts and iron-willed resolve, we can finally put an end to this menace. Magsisilbi itong makabuluang legacy para sa ating lahat na bahagi ng 19th Congress. This will also be our major contribution in the current administration hopes para bagong Pilipinas.
Maganda yung nabasa kong comment, oh, sabi ni Dexter Cruz. Rodrigo Duterte is the best president of the Philippines ever. I agree.
Pinas. On that note, Mr. Speaker, Mr. Chairman, thank you very much. Nakalpong salamat.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Dong Gonzalez Jr. Before we acknowledge the next speaker, may we acknowledge the presence of
Anyway, nagpapakilala pa sila. Ha? Ang punto kasi ng mga speaker natin dito ngayon na pinapanood, uulitin ko lamang po, yung parang suma total ng kanilang mga naging hearing sa bawat committee na kanila pong pinamunuan. Narinig po natin kay Congressman Gonzales yung particular na pangyayari doon po sa Pampanga, kung saan nagkaroon po ng noon ay pinakamalaking pagkakasabat sa illegal na droga ng kasalukuyang gobyerno. At ang mga tinutukoy po na tao doon na maaaring may kinalaman ay mga taong may ugnayan kay Rodrigo Duterte, particular si Michael Yang. Pakinggan natin si Congressman Fernandez.
Joint committee hearings that were conducted with Committee on Games and Amusement. Yung po mga testimonies, mga resource persons and witnesses, we will be giving it to all the members for their perusal para makita po nila yung naging tema ng aming pong hearing nung nakaraang apat na hearings. Good afternoon, esteemed colleagues. On behalf of the members of the Committee on Public Order and Safety, kinagagalak po namin at kami ay nagpapasalamat sa pamunuan ng Kongreso na kami ay bahagi ng malawakang investigasyon sa committee. hanggang sa unti-unti nating natuklasan ang pagkakakonekta at kaugnayan ng mga key personalities sa bawat aspeto ng ating pagsisiyasat. The Committee on Public Order and Safety is mandated to look into all matters directly and principally relating to the suppression of criminality, including those on illegal gambling, private armies, terrorism, organized crime, and illegal drugs. As a matter of fact, the committee has been holding a series of hearings into the illegal by-bus operations being conducted by unscrupulous members of drug enforcement units of the Philippine National Police. On July 5, 2024, the Speaker ordered a comprehensive congressional investigation into the criminal activities linked to POGOS. He declared that the move will underscore the government's commitment to curbing illegal activities and ensure that existing regulations are effectively enforced. He further stated that it is imperative to identify and unmask the masterminds and protectors behind the illegal POGO operation so that they can be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. Pursuant to the directive of the Speaker, the Committees on Public Order and Safety and Games and Amusements commenced the joint motu proprio inquiry in aid of legislation into the proliferation of criminal activities and unlawful acts linked to POGOS, with the end in view of recommending corrective actions. The congressional investigation shall further result in recommendation for the enactment of a legislative measure with the ironclad provisions against the resurgence of POGOS. The Committees on Public Order and Safety and Games and Amusement conducted 4 meetings, with the initial hearing held on July 17, 2024, and succeeding hearings on July 23, 31, and August 7, 2024. On August 5, 2024, the committee chairpersons, together with the Speaker, the Senior Deputy Speaker, and fellow legislators also conducted an ocular inspection of Sun Yu One Technology Incorporated, which is situated in the Baupo compound in Bamban, Tarlac, and Lucky South 99.
O, ito namang sinasabi ni Congressman Dan Fernandez, ang suma total po nito, yung POGO at ang mga krimen sa likod po nito, particular ang pagpatay, human trafficking, money laundering, at iba pa. O, yan po, para lang magkaroon tayo ng maikling konteksto sa mga napapakinggan po natin.
Which is located in the multi-hectare Royal Thai Court property in Porac, Pampanga. These POGO hubs have been shuttered following joint law enforcement operations conducted early this year. During our initial hearing, we found out that among the crimes associated to POGOS are murder and homicide, human trafficking, torture, prostitution, forcible abduction, kidnap for ransom.
Natawa ako sa komento ng isang tanga. Sabi niya, ikaw top one, mukha kang pera, karma is real. Paano karma is real? Ha? Ang lahat ng tao dapat mukhang pera. Kasi kung hindi ka mukhang pera, pero dapat sa tamang kaparaanan, hindi ka mabubuhay. Kaya nga ka naghahanap buhay para kumita ng pera. Pero dapat hindi sa masamang kaparaanan. Kapag ka ikaw ay tumatanggap ng bayad para siraan ng ibang tao, masama yun. Ha? At hindi ganun si Top 1. Ngayon, kung karma ang sinasabi mo, sino ba nakakarma ngayon? Sino ba ang nasampahan po ng kaso, samot sari? Anyway, nakalimutan ko na naman. Lagi kong sinasabi ito, pag pumatol ka sa tanga, dalawa na kayong tanga. I'm sorry, napapatol ako doon sa tanga.
Robbery, extortion, drug trafficking, cybercrime, money laundering, and tax evasion. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission presented a video on the extent of disinuous criminal activities linked to POGOS. Kung gusto niyo po makakuha ng mga videos, meron po tayo. Ibibigay po natin sa lahat ng mga members and even the torture victims for you to comprehend the gravity of the situation. The PAOC also presented a timeline of events in Bamban, Tarlac, highlighting the role of former Mayor Alice Lialgo in facilitating the establishment of POGO operation in that area. Also presented
was evidence of alleged involvement of individuals like Xiang Wang and Bernard Chua in the POGO operations. The committees also heard the testimony of Mr. Dilan, a victim of human trafficking. Meron din po tayong video ibibigay sa ating mga members. The committee also discussed so many related matters that include ang jurisdiction ng PAGCOR. Ano ba ang jurisdiction nila sa issuance ng executive orders and regulation covering offshore gaming from 2016 up to present? Ano ang mga responsibilidad ng ating pong mga LGUs? May kinalaman po ba ang mga mayors? May kinalaman po ba ang mga congressman? May kinalaman po ba ang mga senador? At may kinalaman po ba ang mga dating at dati't kasalukuyang mga namumuno sa ating bansa? The crucial mission ng Bureau of Immigration is also at stake. The responsibility of the National Telecommunication Commission, the DTI, the DICT, ating mga telcos companies in exposing the fraud committed by illegal POGOs in preventing the misuse of SIM card registration and distribution and in providing valuable data on internet usage. Importante din po yung AMLAC sapagkat dito po natin nakita ang koneksyon ng pag-ikot ng pera ng involved sa BOGO at ganoon din po sa drug syndicate. Further, based on the testimonies of the administrators of the Cagayan Economic Zone, pati na po yung sa APAB, pati na yung sa Aurora, the committees found out that POGO do not operate in these areas. During the succeeding hearings, the committees heard the testimonies of many personalities like Attorney Harry Roque, si Mayor Jing Capili, si Mr. Dennis Cunanan, Julian Linsangan, and among others, at marami pang iba. These all personalities that I mentioned, you can get the copy of all this report that we have submitted to all the members. The committees also heard the statement of our esteemed Presidential Legal Counsel Secretary and former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, as well as former PAGCOR Chairperson Andrea Domingo, into the proliferation of POGO operation. They noted that POGO operation were not prevalent before 2016. Bago po ang 2016, wala.
Narinig nyo mga DD sheets? Bago ang 2016, meron ng mga POGO. Pero hindi po kalat at hindi laganap. Pero noong 2016 na nanungkulan na itong si Rodrigo Duterte, umalat at naging laganap. The heyday of POGO particular is 2019. Ayon po sa spokesperson po ng Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission na si Winston Casio. At ito pong paok na ito, ginawa pong inutil ito ni Rodrigo Duterte. Bakit? Eh kayo na ang humusga. Kasi trabaho ng paok yun eh. At ginawang inutil ni Rodrigo Duterte, hindi nakapagtrabaho ang paok, thus resulting doon sa proliferation ng POGO sa Pilipinas.
Tapo masyadong POGO, but the situation changed after the issuance of Executive Order number 13 in 2017, which mandated the regulation of POGO operations. Mahaba pa po ito. Pero iiklihan ko na lang po talaga mga kasama. Nagpapasalamat na po ang aking mga kasamahan. At yung matrix naman po that we created, we have the copy of the matrix about the investigation that was conducted by the poor chairman, and then we collated in one matrix. And so we will be giving that to all the members as well. Our investigation have uncovered preliminary findings linking POGO operation to drug trafficking and money laundering. The matrix highlights the interconnectedness of various individuals and corporations, demonstrating how seemingly unrelated entities are connected through shared incorporators, business ventures, and financial transaction. As I have repeatedly stated, we need to ferret out.
Natawa ako sa comment ng isang tanga pero di ko siya papatulan. Sabi niya, I am bullshit. Sabi niya, di ko papatulan, dabasahin ko lang sa inyo. President Duterte is the best president. God knows. Naniniwala ba kayo doon mga tol? Naniniwala ba kayo sa sinabi ng isang tangang didishit? Best president daw si Rodrigo Duterte. God knows. Nak ng teting na yan.
the truth and identify the perpetrators of these illegal activities and hold them accountable for the crimes they committed and ensure that the victim...
Naglalabasan yung mga tanga, oh. Mga tangang didisits. Hindi ba kayo natatangahan sa sarili ninyo? Galit na galit kayo sa akin. Mumurahin ninyo ko. Tatawagin nyo ako ng ulol. Pero nanonood kayo sa akin. Hindi ko makuha yung logic, mga tol, eh. Biro inyo, binibigyan nyo ng stress sarili ninyo. Mura kayo ng mura sa akin. Galit na galit kayo niyan. Kasi hindi ka magmumura nang hindi ka nagagalit. Kayo yung nagbibigay ng stress sa sarili ninyo. Di ba kayo naaawa sa sarili ninyo? Eh kami, happy lang dito. Ako, mataas lang ang boses ko, malakas ang boses ko. Ganun lang talaga ako, pero happy kami dito. Sayang, wala yung itok-itok. Di ko tuloy ma-play eh.
...of these crimes obtained true justice. My dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to end by reiterating this quote. Ginamit na po ni SDS kanina yung quote ni Edmund Burke. Eh, yun din po ang gagamitin ko. Eh, wala na ako magagawa. Ginamit na niya. Ang sabi ni SDS, the only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is...
Nakakahiya naman sa mga tatangang-tangang DD sheets na ito. Tingnan nyo nga ang itsura ko kung mga akong adik, mga tol. Ikumpara nyo nga ako sa itsura ni Rodrigo Duterte. Ha? Ikumpara nyo nga ako doon sa video ni Baste Duterte. Ano ba utak meron ng mga DD sheets? Nasa talampakan ba talaga? Hindi ako pumapatol sa particular, ha? In general na ito. Nasa talampakan ba mga utak ninyo, mga tangang DD sheets? Sa bagay, kapwa nyo nga supporter ni Rodrigo Duterte, ang tawag sa inyo, bobo at tanga kayo eh. Diba sabi ni Banat Boy, mga bobo at tanga ang mga nanonood kay Maharlucca. Oh, karamihan sa inyo na mga DD sheets nanonood kay Maharlucca eh. Mga bobo at tanga talaga kayo.
For good men to do nothing. Diba? Tatagulugin ko na lang po. Para magtagumpay ang masasama, eh dapat walang gawin ang mabubuti. Kaya kung mabubuti po kayo, kumilos tayo. At kung masama kayo, huwag kayong kumilos. Maraming salamat.
Narinig nyo yun? Kung mabubuti po tayo, kumilos po tayo, magsalita po tayo katulad ng ginagawa natin ngayon. Etong mga DD sheets na ito, hindi ko alam kung ano pinaghuhugutan ng mga ito eh. O sige nga mga DD sheets, bigyan ko nga kayo ng pagkakataon, ibababa ko ang StreamYard ko, umakit kayo dito at makipag-argumento kayo ng maayos sa akin. Walang murahan. Diskurso tayo, walang murahan. Ilatag ninyo yung mga accomplishment ni Rodrigo Duterte. O baka mapaniwala nyo po kami. Ito ang StreamYard, akyat kayo mga tanga. O yan na. Baka sabihin ninyo, eh, nagmamagaling lang ako dito. Yan ang pagkakataon. Binibigay ko sa inyo ang platform ko. Magpakita kayo sa camera, humarap kayo ngayon at ilatag nyo, bakit best president si Rodrigo Duterte? Kasi nilalatag namin ngayon kung bakit worst president si Rodrigo Duterte. Eh, nadinig na natin. Mula sa mga chairperson ng mga committee na ito, may dalawa pang magsasalita dyan. Ha? Akyat! Nakunang teting kayo.
At magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Thank you very much, Chairman Dan Fernandez of the Committee on Public Order and Safety. Before we proceed with the next speaker, please allow me to recognize Representative Micaela Swansing. Representative...
By the way, mamayang alas 9 po ng gabi na kay Carclaya YouTube channel po tayo at talakayan po tayo ulit doon. At sana hindi ko makalimutan, alas 9 ng gabi, subaybayan niyo po kami mamaya sa YouTube channel ni Carclaya. Ang topic namin, yung tambalustay na vice presidente.
At Chino Almario, Representative Zia Alonto Adyong, and Representative Khalid Dimaporo. Welcome to the joint committee hearing. The next speaker is the chairman of the Committee on Human Rights, Representative Bienvenido M. Abante Jr. You are now recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Sa lahat ng ginawa sa Duterte administration, ito na po ang pinaka-worst. Ito na po, itong mapapakinggan po natin.
What do we make of suffering of our people beyond what they can bear? Have we ever imagined in our lifetime the loss of lives of so many women, children, poor and underprivileged, some of whom had become victims of vices of drugs and wrongdoings. Many of them, perhaps all of them, who were violently shut up, were innocent until proven guilty by the courts of law. And yet, none of those thousands instantly killed during the war on drugs policy of the past administration were exacted with justice. Our Constitution declares, and I quote, "No person shall be deprived of life, liberty, and property without due process of law, nor shall any person be deprived the equal protection of the laws." But this constitutional provision was unceremoniously blotted out by the blood and tears of the victims of extrajudicial killing. From 7,640 illegal drug suspects who died in police operations to a total of recorded 20,322 deaths for the period of July 1, 2016 to November 27, 2017.
O mga DDCits, okay lang sa inyo yun na 20,322 ang napatay dahil sa walang kwentang war on drugs ni Rodrigo Duterte? Okay lang sa inyo yun? Ha? Tanungin ko kayo, okay lang kayo doon? Kasi ako minsan nakukonsensya ako eh. Ha? Minsan nakukonsensya talaga ako. Pulis pa ako, bahagi ako ng war on drugs. Mga hinayupa kayo. Pero wala tayong magagawa nung time na yon. Susunod ka sa utos eh. Legal naman yung inuutos eh. Operasyon eh. Oh. Kaya kayo, bago kayo magsasalita, kung kayo'y ayon doon, sana nasuot nyo muna yung mga sapatos eh ng mga taong involved doon para alam nyo kung ano yung nararamdaman nila. Ha? Okay lang sa inyo, 20,322? Ako, di ko alam na ganun karami yun. Basta ang alam lang namin, dapat may accomplishment ang istasyon. Otherwise, magkakaproblema.
Or a daily average of 39.46 deaths. The death of one person is a tragedy. The deaths of thousands is an even greater tragedy. Isaiah 1:17 and Psalm 82, verse number 3, tell us, and I quote, "Learn to do well, seek judgment, relieve the oppressed, judge the fatherless, plead for the widow, defend the poor and fatherless, do justice to the afflicted and needy." Today, the journey of ferreting the truth, seeking justice and healing of our people begins with this very important meeting. Good afternoon, honorable members and chairman of the Joint Committee on Dangerous Drugs, Public Order and Safety, and Public Accounts. The Committee on Human Rights has conducted 5 public hearings and 1 briefing on the alleged extrajudicial killings or EJ case committed during the implementation of the war on drugs policy under the administration of former President Rodrigo Duterte. In the agenda were House Resolution Number 14, introduced by Representative Raul Daniel Emanuel, in privileged speech of Representative Castro, delivered in the plenary on November 8, 2023. Pursuant to its mandate under the rules of the House, the Committee on Human Rights is cognizant that our inquiry in aid of legislation focuses on, and I quote, "all matters directly and principally relating to the protection and enhancement of human rights, assistance to victims of human rights violations and their families, the prevention of violations of human rights, and the punishment of perpetrators of such violations. In the exercise of the constitutional powers of Congress to conduct inquiries in aid of legislation articulated in Section 21, Article 6 of the Constitution, the committee abides by the House Rules of Procedure governing inquiries in aid of legislation and have respected the rights of our witnesses of due process, interparliamentary courtesy, and legal processes required in the inquiry. Incumbent and former public officials from the Office of the President, the Philippine National Police, the Commission on Human Rights, the National Bureau of Investigation, the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, the Department of Interior and Local Government, Office of the Solicitor General, and other relevant government officers were invited and heard during the hearings to shed light on pertinent issues in the inquiry. A total of 21 relatives of victims attended the hearings, together with the Rights Up for Life and for Rights advocates and legal counsels from the National Union of People's Lawyers and Center for International Law, and narrated the circumstances surrounding the deaths of their family members. The committee likewise issued invitations to the incumbent senator, Honorable Ronald Bato de la Rosa, as well as the former president, Rodrigo Duterte, Attorney Harry Roque, former presidential spokesperson, DOJ Secretary Gizmin Remulla, and former Solicitor General Attorney Jose Calida. However, the aforementioned personalities failed to appear before the committee. The committee has identified the following as the key issues to be resolved in our inquiry. Number one, whether human rights violations have been committed against civilians, particularly on women and children, during the implementation of the anti-illegal drugs campaign of the Duterte administration. Number two, whether the state's obligation to respect, protect, and fulfill human rights have been fully adhered in the course of the anti-illegal drugs campaign. And number three, whether domestic and international human rights laws, instruments, and governmental policies have been adequate and responsive to the promotion, protection, and fulfillment of human rights by obligation. Thus, please allow the chairperson to discuss the issues and findings in seriatim. As preparatory on the statistical data on the extrajudicial killings, the committee had been presented with multiple reports indicating that there had been massive nationwide drug-related killings within the period July 2016 to June 2022. The killings were classified to have been implemented by police operations, unknown perpetrators, similar to Sinaloa type of killings, which were notorious in Latin America drug cartel. The 2017 year-end accomplishment report of the Duterte administration highlighted as key accomplishments the deaths of 3,967 drug personalities and 16,355 homicide cases under investigation as of 30 September 2017. In addition, the PNP reported that there was a total of 7,640 illegal drug suspects who died in police operations. 2,053 of these were recorded in the first 6 months, July to December of 2016. Meanwhile, other government agencies and international human rights organizations, such as the CHR and the United Nations Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights, domestic human rights organizations, such as the Free Legal Assistance Group, and Third World Studies, University of the Philippines, Diliman have their respective data vetted from their own investigations and information gathering devices. With CAFR's investigation of the 3,900 cases of drug-related killings, it has observed that killings in relation to the anti-legal drug campaign have been widespread, expanding across all administrative regions in the country. The UNOHCHR reported in their report dated June 2020 that there were at least 8,663 drug-related killings as of February of 2019. Academic research from the HAS project of UP gathered around 5,348 recorded deaths. Attorney Chel Jokno of FLAG cited unassailable data which were stated in a Supreme Court en banc extended resolution that indicated that the Duterte administration's anti-drug war from July 1, 2016 to November 27, 2017 recorded a total of 20,322 deaths or a daily average of 39.46 deaths.
39 na tao kada araw ang pinapatay sa panahon ni Rodrigo Duterte. Tapos masaya pa kayo mga D-Digits. Anong utak meron kayo? Ngayon, ayusin natin ang argumento. Walang ad hominem. Walang murahan. Walang pagsasalita ng hindi maganda. Kung hindi punto lang por punto. Lalaban ba kayo? Mga Duterte supporter? Sina-challenge ko kayo ngayon. Live. Pwede kayong umakyat dito sa programa ko at makipagdiskurso sa atin. Walang ad hominem. Sabihin ninyo kung bakit best president si Rodrigo Duterte. Kasi sa paniniwala namin, pinakawalang hiyang naging presidente si Rodrigo Duterte. Pinaka-worst na naging presidente. Paliwanagan nyo kami. Baka sakali mapaniwala nyo kami. Nandyan ang StreamYard at muli kong ibabalik. Oh, akyat kayo. Walang murahan. Walang ad hominem. Punto por punto lamang. Welcome kayo sa programa ko ngayon. Bilangan ko kayo. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Akit na! Welcome! Kasi mahilig kayong makipag-argumento eh. Di ba? Sabi ninyo, worst president si Pangulong Bongbong Marcos dahil bangag at addict siya. Patunayan natin ngayon. Ito na! Kung wala kayong maa-argumentong maayos at puro ad hominem na lang kayo, eh salamat pa rin. Kasi mga tanga kayo at sumusuporta kayo sa channel ko. Dahil yung mga matatalino, alam nila kung ano yung sinasabi po namin dito. Pero kayong mga tanga, galit na galit kayo sa akin, minumura nyo ko, binibigyan nyo lamang ang sarili nyo ng stress. Huwag nyong bigyan ang sarili nyo ng stress, huwag kayong manood sa akin. Kasi kung manonood kayo sa akin at mananatili kayong galit, eh ang tanga nyo, sarili ninyo, ini-stress ninyo. Katangahan po yon. Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyo mga tol.